Hi viewers, I'm Dilip Kumar Intur here. Today I'm gonna show you how to insert a Word or a PowerPoint document into Excel spreadsheet. You don't have to close your Excel working sheet, but you can just embed them inside it. Sounds interesting? I'll show you how to do it. Here we go. I have a set of datas here. And I'm going to include, let's say I'm going to include a Word document here below this tabular. So for this, I have to go to insert and then I have to choose object. I have to choose drop down. I have to choose Word document. Here you have the Word document. Here you can click here as you want to show that as an icon, or if you don't want an icon, just leave that unchecked and then say OK. Here's your Word document. So this is an embedded Word document. So here I can do the typing. I'm gonna say welcome to Excel learning. I'm gonna add more text. So I've added more text. Okay, I'm gonna make this bold. Okay, yes, we have a Word document here embedded in Excel. So how do I insert an image in Word document? Go to insert, picture, and choose any picture. I'm gonna choose this heartin. Yes, we have this. Just click on this and I'm gonna say text wrapping square, and you have text around. So this is the Word document I have embedded here. Let's keep this, and you can do the color part just as this normal, like how you do it in Word. Okay, and I'm going to click outside to exit out of the editing this document. So this is just like an image here. You want to edit, you have to double click like this and it will open up like this, right? I'm going to click outside, which means I'm exiting from it. I'm going to include PPT now. So I'm just going to scroll down. I'm going to choose PowerPoint. Okay, Microsoft PowerPoint. So here we have Excel. I'm going to drag this to increase the, okay, I'm going to say welcome to Excel, say subtitle easy learning. Right, okay, fine. Now I have exited from the PowerPoint. So I'm going to double click and play the PowerPoint, then enter. So for now I have only one slide. If I have to include more slides, then I have to say right click or just double click and say grouping, present object. I'm going to say edit. Okay, and here is the edit. If I have to include any animation part, right click, just like how you do it in PowerPoint, you can do it here. But you need to know some kind of shortcuts to include slides to your PPT here. I'm going to use the shortcut Control M to include another slide, Excel. I'm going to say Excel chapter. I'm going to include one image here. I'm going to use, okay, let me use the same image. Okay, I'm going to say F5 to play the show, then enter. I have the second slide. Yes, now we have included PowerPoint in our Excel spreadsheet. And I'm going to show you one more thing, like how to give a link to a document, particular document. Instead of embedding it, I want to keep that as an external thing. So how do I do it? I'm going to insert an icon over here. I'm going to the object, and then here you have another tab, create from file, browse, choose your file. I'm going to choose a file here. I'm going to choose one file. Okay, I am choosing a document here. I can even select whether link to the file or display as icon. So this link to file is, it's always safe that whenever you are making changes to the external file, and when you click here, those changes you can always get updated. But when you display it as icon, so it is like embedded. So I'm going to use the link here, link to file. Okay, or what if I link to, I can choose change the icon. I can say I can leave that or change that in, and caption I can say double click. I'm going to say double click to open, double click to open the file, or I'll leave it as double click to open. Okay, then okay, yes, it's getting loaded. Yes, you have the file here, icon. So I'm going to double click this here to open the document, Word document. I've opened this, I make any changes here, it'll automatically get saved. Like I'm going to make changes here, it will not ask you for any save pop-up message. So I'm going to just type and close this. So it's automatically saved. So you have to be very careful, so there's no undo. It'll automatically save once you exit. So, and then how am I to include a video file? I'm going to include a video file here. Just browse for a video file. I'm going to use some short. Okay, I'm going to fear files. Okay, so it's like an external one. So if I double click this, you get the video played, and same way you for playing the music as well. Okay, done. I hope you enjoyed this video. Click like if you like this video. Subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.